Hi everyone, it's Carolina from Gotta Love Polish and welcome back to my channel. I am so super excited to do this video and I wanted to let you guys know from the beginning, this is gonna be a long one. I'm gonna be talking about my favorite seasonal nail polishes, which is the fall autumn polishes, and I am so excited. This is the 1 year anniversary of the big nail polish community collaboration that Walker from Olive Ave Nails had started back in 2018. I freaking loved it. When I went into my YouTube and I saw all of these channels that I watched doing a collaboration out of my favorite fall, like my favorite polishes of all time. So I was super excited when she decided to do it again, because I know that we've all done it, but things change, seasons change, people change, our tastes change. So I'm just so excited, you guys. You have no idea. So I want to say thank you so much to Walker and all of the ladies that are participating in this collaboration. I'm going to have everybody's information down on the drop box below, so check them out. I'm actually going to do this the way that Josephine from Polish Talk did her summer collection. She talked about the polishes in color categories, from the ones that she had the most of to the ones that she has the least of. But there's one more thing that I want to add. I'm going to do a little twist for that one. I'm going to do my classics and my new kids. The classics are going to be the ones that I've worn for multiple years in a row. You know, the colors that I've had for a while that like speak fall to me. And then the new kids are going to be the ones that I talk about that are new to me, which is like maybe a year or two. If they're like less than a year, basically. So it has to be like at least a year. So those are the new to me favorites. I'm so excited to do this, guys. Like, seriously so excited to do this. I hope you guys enjoy this. And again, like I said, it's a long video. It's already been a long intro. So thank you guys so much. And I hope you enjoy the content. Hi guys. So real quick before I continue on, I'm pretty sure I mentioned it in my intro, but just in case, I am wearing It's a Piazza Cake from OPI with OPI Pure 15K White Gold on top, and on my accent nails is China Glaze. I'm not lying. I just want to give you guys a heads up in case you're wondering what I'm wearing. I'm going to try to be better about making sure I mention them before I start the video. We're going to start out with the yellow mustardy shades for fall. I actually don't have any classic mustard to talk about because mustard or yellowish polish are kind of new to me, so I'm calling them all new kits, and these have all been seen before. The first one I'm going to talk about is, of course, OPI Never a Dullest Moment. OPI Never a Dullest Moment was the first mustardy yellow that I remember myself purchasing from a mainstream brand, and I really enjoyed the way this looked. My friend thought that I was crazy for buying this polish. She thought it looked like kind of like baby poop or baby throw up, but I thought it looked fantastic, and so I bought it, and I'm really glad that I did. You guys are getting a little bit of a sneak peek of all my other colors here, but this is Never a Dullest Moment by OPI, and as you guys can see, it is a very, very pretty light mustardy yellow. Definitely compared to my other summery or spring yellows, you can definitely tell that this is more of a mustard shade, but compared to everything else that I'm going to show you, it looks kind of light, but I still love it, and the formula is fantastic in two colors. The next mustardy yellow that I'm going to talk about is from 90 Lacquer, and this is Corn Maze. I believe this is from her first collection that she released, obviously not the like classic one because it has the newer stickers, but when I saw this color, I was like, oh my gosh, I have got to get my hands on that. And this one and another one that I am going to talk about in this video, I purchased and I didn't wear them right away, which is crazy because all I wanted to do was wear these polishes, but I'm really glad that I did eventually wear them. And this is a fantastic formula in two coats. It's definitely, I'm gonna try to zoom you guys in a little bit more there. It's definitely a little bit, you can see the hollow. Oh, we got a gnat in the room here, but you can see the hollow in the swatch wheel here. This is just two coats, and the formula was fantastic. It really was. I absolutely love wearing this, especially on those days that there's still sun out in the fall. I feel like it looks just so pretty with the hollow going through it. It's just beautiful. And the last polish that I'm going to talk about is from Rescue Beauty Lounge. Unfortunately, Rescue Beauty Lounge no longer makes polishes, and this is Footpath. Now Footpath, I would say, is the first kind of yellow mustard color that I purchased, period. But it was an indie. I did purchase this when they were going out of business, because Rescue Beauty Lounge was like $20, and I was just like, that is way too much money to be spending on a polish. I couldn't make myself spend that much money. And when they were going out of business, you know, everything was on clearance, and I decided to purchase it, and I'm really glad that I did. I really enjoy the way that this looks. It's definitely leans a little bit more brown. This is it right here, and it definitely leans a little bit more brown than the other two. In fact, I did a nail wheel earlier in the year with all of my mustard polishes, and this is definitely more like a Dijon mustard dark polish than all of my other ones. Like my other, like this is a, like the spicy mustard, I guess. But I really enjoy it. I still think it looks really great. And I definitely would recommend like a dark mustardy kind of color. The next color category we're going to talk about is pink, and I actually don't have that many pinks to share with you guys. The first one I'm going to talk about is this one from OPI. I'm going to have a lot of OPIs in this video, guys, because I have definitely have been an OPI fan for a long time. Now this is the classic. This is the one that I'm gonna say it's a classic, and this is Don't Bossa Nova Me Around. It's like a taupey pink. I still consider it a pink. I don't put it with my taupes. I put it with my pinks just because I feel like it looks like a pink. It looks like a light nudie pink. So this is what it looks like on the swatch wheel right here. So as you can tell, it's still like kind of neutral, kind of nude, but I still think that it looks fabulous during the fall time. I think this came out in the spring, maybe in the summer collection. I'm not sure, I can't remember right now, but I know that I love wearing it during the fall time. And this is kind of like, it was my any time of the year polish, I would wear this one. But that one has been replaced by the one I'm gonna talk about next. But this does take two coats to be completely opaque. The formula is fantastic, and I think that anybody who wears this during the fall won't regret it. It's just a really flattering shade of pinky nude. The one that I'm gonna talk about next that have totally eclipsed my OPI Don't Bossa Nova Me Around is this one from KB Shimmer, and this is That's Nude to Me. I have talked about this polish before. This is a polish that I can wear any time of the year. I seriously feel like this one, I mean, just any time of the year, guys, like summer, spring, fall, winter, anytime. I love the way that this looks. I find that it's very flattering. It's just like this perfect wash of slight pinky tone. For me, it's like almost like my nails, but better, because you know it has hollow. I love that it has hollow. It just gives it a bit of an extra oomph that other polishes just don't have. And I really enjoy wearing this during any time of the year, but especially in the fall when I need a palette cleanser from all the dark, bold polishes that I end up wearing during the fall. Fall palette without a rose gold. I feel like you need to wear rose gold during the fall. It's just the perfect combination. And this one that I'm gonna talk about is from Cirque Colors. As you can tell, it's an older one. And this is Halcyon. Halcyon is a very, very popular color. As you guys can tell, I have the old label. this polish has been with me for a while now. Oh, and if I didn't mention it, the KB Shimmer and the Halcyon are both the new kids on the block. The classic was the OPI. So Halcyon is my perfect rose gold. I do have another rose gold from another indie brand that I have not yet worn, so I can't say that it's the perfect rose gold. I really like it, but until I wear it, I can't say. So this is going to be the top contender for rose gold polish. Before this one, it was Orly's Rage, but this, you know, the Cirque color has definitely eclipsed it. This is what Halcyon looks like on the nail wheel. As you guys can tell, it's very pretty. I feel like it's a very flattering rose gold shade. It definitely looks rose gold. It doesn't lean too bronzy, in my opinion. So yeah, so if you guys, this is still at the website. This is still on the website, so you guys can definitely get your hands on it, and I think that it's fantastic. This took only 2 coats to get opaque on my nails as well as on the swatch wheel. And the final pink that I'm going to talk about is another Cirque color, and this is Stoneware from Cirque Colors. This is a recent purchase from last year, I want to say. I think I got it last year, maybe in 2017. I can't remember. But I remember that I put it on and I absolutely loved it. And this is what it looks like here. This is one of their like kind of speckled polishes basically. And it's this light white, not really white, it's like a light pinky white color with, as you can, I don't know if you guys can tell in the video, but it has some gold shimmery microscopic glitters, and then this like kind of coppery microscopic glitters. I don't know, it looks so beautiful. It definitely looks like what it's named after, the stoneware, the you know, the kitchen items. I can't think of what they're called right now, it's really late for me. And so yeah, I really enjoy the way that looks. I hope you guys can see all the little speckles there. I'm trying to get it to zoom in a little bit closer, but yeah, it's such a pretty color. Another palette cleanser for sure. I do tend to wear a lot of dark colors during the winter time, excuse me, the fall time, and I think that this is like one of the prettiest palette cleansers that I have. Okay, we're gonna move on to the oranges, and for oranges I only have 4 polishes to talk about. I'm trying to do this quick because I know there's a lot of polishes, and the first one we're gonna talk about is obviously the one that I am wearing, which it's a Piazza Cake by OPI. This is a polish, and I've mentioned it in my videos before, so if you've heard me say it, I'm sorry, you're gonna hear me say it again. This is a polish that I have to wear every year. It has become tradition. First day of fall, it's a Piazza Cake. Sometime during the fall time, I will wear this again with another top or another accent nail or something. I just absolutely love this color. Now it is coming across a little bit brighter on the viewfinder, on the view screen, than it is in real life. It is a burnt orange color that I feel personally is the best, most flattering shade for fall. I have it right here on the nail wheel, and obviously I'm wearing it right now, but this is what it would look like without any top coat or any extra bling on top of it. I seriously love the way that this looks, and it's just my favorite burnt orange shade of all time. Another shade that I absolutely love is from China Glaze, and this one is gonna be a little bit harder to get. This is Riveting, and it is from the China Glaze and Hunger Games collection. I bought so many polishes from that collection. I absolutely loved a lot of them. Now this one for me, I do use in 3 coats. It's technically opaque in 2 coats. If you have longer nails, you probably need a third one anyways, but I just think that putting it in 3 kind of intensifies the color and makes it just like bam in your face, and I absolutely love how fiery this looks. This is definitely one of those colors, and this is what it looks like right here. This is definitely one of those colors that like in the sun I was mesmerized. I remember I was wearing this and I was driving, and I seriously had to like just look at my nails when I had this on. It was so pretty, guys. Like, I absolutely loved it. I think that this has been duped by now. I mean, it's a pretty old polish, and it's not that unique in the sense that it's an orange with gold fleck shimmers, you know. I'm sure other brands have done it. In fact, I want to say that 90 has one that's very similar, but I cannot remember its name. I want to say Fireside, something with the fire. I'm not sure, but you guys can go check it out and see if she has it on her website. But I absolutely love this color. This is my favorite. It's very well loved. I wish I hadn't moved it around so you guys can see how much I have used of this polish. But it's a very well loved polish, and again, this one, because of the formulation, I would recommend 3 coats. I just feel like it intensifies the color. If you have short nails like I do right now, you might get away with 2 coats and be fine. Long nails probably need 3, but just to intensify that color, to give you a little bit more of a bam, I would do it with 3 anyway. And this has to be one of my lightest orange that isn't a summer color, and this is from Butter London. Butter London, and this is Silly Billy. Silly Billy, I do believe, came out in the summer. I remember Butter London did this collection in the summertime that looked like a fall collection, and people were very confused by it, but I loved it, and this one was the one that I chose. I didn't buy many of that one. I just bought this one, I believe, and maybe one other, but I can't remember. But I find that I can still wear this in the winter time, or excuse me, in the fall time. I just feel like it's like, kinda, it looks on the viewfinder sort of like macaroni and cheesy kind of orange, but it's actually a little bit deeper than that. It's a pumpkin orange to me. Like, it's coming up a lot brighter on the camera than it is in real life, and this is definitely more like a pumpkin kind of orange. It's perfectly opaque in two coats. I absolutely love it. I feel like this is the best fall time orange. The last color that I'm gonna talk about is another 90, and this is Pumpkin Everything, like Maïs. I think this came out in her first collection because she came out with her collection in the fall time, and I needed this color so badly, and I am so glad that I got it. I think that it's a very flattering browny pumpkin-y shade, because it's definitely leans more brown compared to the other ones that I have on here, but I just feel like it's such a pretty shade, guys. Like, it's definitely one of those colors that just looks very flattering on the nail. I love how the holographics of it. Well, you can't have a fall collection video without talking about some browns, and I surprised myself by pulling out 5 browns that are my favorite from all time. The first one I'm going to talk about is the OPI Warm and Fuzzy. This is obviously the classic. In fact, I think all 5 of these are classics. I don't have any new kids to share with you guys. But this is a polish that I have worn since it came out every Thanksgiving. Every Thanksgiving since I purchased this polish, I have worn it. It's a tradition, just like the It's a Piazza Cake. This does take 3 coats just because it's such a thin formula. It's an older OPI one. I feel like their collections used to be very, very thin. But not only that, but it's that glass fleck, you know, layerable polish. In fact, I do believe that you can put this on as a topper. It is kind of heavy and dense, so it will cover up whatever you're wearing underneath, but it'll give you an interesting transitional, like a transition color. I keep wanting to say transition, but that's not what I mean. Anyways, so this is definitely one of my favorites of all time. It's one of the only browns that I actively want to wear. This is what it looks like on here on the swatch wheel. It only has 2 coats, but definitely it's a 3 coater for me, whether I have long nails or short nails. It's a very light polish, very sheer polish, but I still love it, and I think it's perfect for the fall time. Next one is another OPI, and this one is also a classic, and this is You Don't Know Jacques. You Don't Know Jacques was the first like vampy dark polish that I remember purchasing or remember wearing, and was like, wow, this is kind of sexy. This is an older polish, and this is an old polish for me. And this is the brown that it looks like right here. It's coming out kind of like milk chocolatey on the viewfinder, but it's definitely a dark, like, taupey brown color that I absolutely love. It was very popular when it came out because nobody else had made something just like this, and I just thought it was so sexy. The third polish that I'm going to talk about is Harvest Moon from China Glaze. Harvest Moon, I believe, was also from the Hunger Games collection. This polish, it's so pretty. It is a very sheer, thin formula, so that kind of sucks because I would love to use this as a stamping polish, but it is a very pretty, very flattering fall brown shade, just because the gold flecks in this, or the, you know, the inner glow of it just makes it look like it's glowing off your nails. I absolutely love it. And this one is really an old one, guys, if you guys can tell, but this one is from China Glaze, and this is Six. Six is from a fall collection that they did. It did like all Roman numerals. So the collection was like 1 through 10, I think, or 1 through 12, I can't remember. But I purchased 6 because I thought it was the most unique at the time. This is a very light peachy brown shade kinda, and it has this pink and gold shimmer in it. It is so pretty. There is a manicure that I actually do with this polish and two other ones that I did not pull out, but that I absolutely love, and I'm gonna have to try to make it, redo it again this fall. But this is a very flattering, almost grandma shade from like just the way that it looks is very flattering, very warm colors that I absolutely love. And the final brown shade is this one from L'Oreal, and this is called Owl's Night. This was a limited edition. I bought it as soon as I saw it because I was like, oh my god, I have to get my hands on this. Now it's coming across kind of green gold in like an olive green on the viewfinder, but honestly it is a brown with lots of gold shimmer. I mean, even here you guys can tell it's a very dark brown with lots of gold shimmer that kind of makes it look kind of greenish, but I seriously love this color so much. So now we're in the blue categories, and I actually narrowed my blues down to two colors, and they're classics only. I did not pull out anything for the new kids, and the first one that I'm going to talk about is the ever classic OPI Ski Teal We Drop. Ski Teal We Drop is a teal blue polish that I think looks so flattering on every skin tone. It's one of my favorite polishes to wear during the fall time. I think it's just so sexy. Look at that. It's dark enough that it's almost black, but you can still tell that it's blue. It's still a teal color. I absolutely love the way this looks, and I usually get a lot of compliments when I wear it. Another one that I want to talk about is the Butter London Victoriana. Victoriana is another oldie for me. I just love, this was so unique at the time when I bought it for me, for my collection. My collection was still pretty new. I could actually fit all my polishes in the into a shoebox at the time. So that tells you guys how old this polish is. And I just think it's just a flattering, like, grayed out blue with all this like silver shimmer in it, and the silver shimmer just kind of gives it a little something extra. I don't know, guys, like, it's just such a pretty color. I don't know, sometimes when it's on the swatch wheel you just can't really tell how beautiful the polish looks, but this was opaque in two coats for the nails and for the swatch wheel. All right, guys, we are almost done. We're going to talk about the greens real quick, and the first green that I'm going to talk about is the ever classic Zombie Zest from China Glaze. This is the old school. I still have this like sticker where I bought it from, but this is Zombie Zest. This is I don't even know, guys. I love swampy, ugly, pretty colors like this. And I remember when I purchased this, my friends would like tell me like, oh my god, that looks so ugly on your nails, and I loved it. I still loved it. It does take three coats to be a semi-opaque for me. It's a very sheer, thin formula. All of these like glass fleck, like, you know, shimmery polishes are kind of like that. I can't, you know, that's just the nature of the beast. So this is just two coats on the wheel. I didn't want to keep using my Zombie Zest because this is, I believe, the only bottle I have. I do have dupes of it, but this is the only original that I have. And I still think that it looks so pretty. So pretty ugly, but so pretty. Another classic green for me is this one from Butter London, and this is Wallace. Oh my gosh, the lady at Ulta gave me like not a hard time about it, but I remember she just like was like, oh, you're gonna buy that one? Like, it was such a, like, I don't know, I have always loved pretty ugly colors like this, and apparently for her this was pretty ugly. This is a kind of coppery kind of green. It comes across sometimes like if it's more like it has bronzy colors in it. I don't know, I freaking love the way that this looks though. It's very, very unique, and nothing else I have compares to this, and trust me, I have looked because I absolutely love this color so much. Another China Glaze that I'm going to talk about is It's Alive, and this one came out in the Halloween collection, another Halloween collection. I think I want to say it came out after Zombie Zest, like the year after, or maybe 2 years after, but this one has more chunky glitters. I absolutely love the way that this looks, however it does tend to chip on me really quickly, as most China Glaze glitter polishes do, but I still love it. I still think it's worth the effort just because it's such a unique polish. I have nothing else that compares to it. And this one is from the This one is from OPI. This one is the Live and Let Die. It's from the Skyfall James Bond collection, which I bought almost all of them. And I absolutely love this. This comes across as a very, very dark green with this greenish gold shimmer in it. But you could barely tell that it's on your nails. When it's on your nails, you can barely tell that it has some shimmer. I can tell, like, as you're wearing it, you can see it a little bit more. This is the last one of the classics, and this is China Glaze Argo. Again, from the Hunger Games collection. I absolutely love the way that this looks. I actually like to wear this in the spring as well for some reason, but this polish, it's, you may think it's similar to Wallace, but it really isn't. It definitely doesn't have that bronzy gold shift to it. It's definitely more just like an inner glow of green. I don't know, but it's just a very sexy color in my opinion. I think that it looks very flattering and perfect for the fall. And the only new kit that I have for greens is this one from Tonic, and this is Lizard Dance. I purchased this last year, I want to say, and I wore it during the fall time, and I got so many compliments. This one lady actually asked me, where did you get this polish? And I told her, I was like, oh, it's this independent brand online. And she goes, no, where, like, what's the website? And so I had to give it to her. I love it because it's like, it's such a shifty, this is definitely more like a duochrome, I suppose. It's such a shifty polish. It comes looking, depending on the angle, you just see different colors, and there's that orangey and that green, and oh, I just love it. So this is definitely a favorite of mine. I kind of wish I would have bought another bottle, but I'm sure that I'll have it for a long time. All right, guys, we're pushing through. I hope you guys take a little break right now and drink something, or go on a bathroom break. The next color category that I'm going to talk about are reds, and I actually only have 5 reds to talk about. I had a little bit more, but I decided to, you know, cut my collection a little bit smaller just because I had so many to talk about in all of the other categories as well. But some of these, I didn't realize how close they look once you swatch them together, but I'm still gonna go by my choices, stick with my guns, and that's what I'm gonna say that are my favorites. The first one that I'm going to talk about is an OPI, and this is Can You Top Us? Can You Top Us This? I absolutely love this color. This is more like a raisin reddish color. This is what it looks like right here. Look how dark and vampy that is. And as you guys can tell, the other colors follow a similar vein. I don't have a classic red fall polish because I end up liking these raisiny, purpley reds, berry reds to wear. But this is Can You Top Us This right here. I absolutely love to wear this. Next color is Malaga Wine, and this is on the viewfinder starting to look a little bit red. This is not a red, guys. This is this polish is a shifty polish. This is a chameleon all by itself. This color is right here. Oh my gosh, it's so sexy. It comes across as a berry wine, and then in certain lights it looks even darker. Sometimes it looks brighter. It's even in the viewfinder right now, it's coming out a little bit redder than it is in real life. But it's definitely, oh my gosh, one of my favorite. I gave this bottle to my best friend thinking that I didn't need one because I was like, oh, I have so many similar shades. And I kept thinking about it, and I was like, no, I had to get it back. I did get it back from her, but I did purchase her own bottle because I felt really bad that I just stole my back from her. But the next polish I'm going to talk about is Skyfall from OPI. Skyfall is another one of the James Bond collection. I freaking love this polish. This is what that one looks like. They're all starting to look the same in the viewfinder, I know, but they really are different in real life. I'm not crazy, guys, seriously. But this one is definitely more of a brown red, like a brick red. I'm gonna put it next to Can You Top Us This, so you guys can see the difference. See how this one is more like a raisin red polish, and this one comes across as more of a brick like red polish. And I freaking love both of them. I can't get rid of them. I've tried destashing these kind of colors, and I just can't. I don't need any more of these kind of colors, so I don't buy these colors anymore, thank God. But it's just, this is such a pretty brick red if you're in the mood for this kind of color. This one, obviously, it's a limited edition OPI. However, I do believe that Zoya Pepper is very similar, very comparable to this color if you're looking for a color like this. and the ever classic OPI Mrs. O'Leary's Barbecue, the original. I love this one and hunted this down for a really long time. I actually had this color and somebody took it from me. That's what happened. I actually purchased this one and somebody had, I had lent them the polish and I never got it back. And again, this is around the time that I didn't realize how limited edition polishes were, but I'm really glad that I got my hands on it. And I sincerely think it's one of the sexiest, vampiest, darkest, like barbecue sauce color. I just can't help it. It's just very pretty. Red that I'm going to talk about is this one from Revlon. This is Autumn Berry. All of my reds for fall are more berry leaning. I know that's what I tend to go for. All of my other reds that I have are either, oops, are either cherry reds for the summer or like Christmassy red. So this one is very special to me because this polish was the polish I was wearing when my husband and I went on our first date. We were going to a friend's wedding and I was wearing this polish, and then the next day we went on our first date. We were friends first and then decided to date, and I was wearing this polish. So this has a lot of sentimental value to me. I absolutely love it. I think it's just a very, not unique, but different, oops, different polish than I have from all of the other polishes that I talk about. It definitely has a little bit of an inner glow to it that just, comes off the nail so pretty. I don't know if you guys can see it. It's just not the same on the camera as it is in real life. Okay guys, and we're down to the final category, which is, has the most polishes. So thank you guys so much for putting up with me for this long. And this is obviously the purple category. Let's get the purple party started with Pampeluna Purple. Pampeluna Purple is a purple that I don't know if it came out in a fall collection, but I love to wear it in the fall. It's a very dark but bright purple. I actually fell in love with this purple. One of my friends, when we used to have nail polish parties, we'd go to each other's houses and we would watch like a TV show or a movie and paint each other's nails. And this was a polish that she had, and every time I would go to this nail polish party, it would be once a week on the weekends, I would have to wear this polish. And so she actually gave me her bottle of Pampeluna Purple. This is the bottle here. And I think that it was just so sweet because I absolutely loved it and she knew how much I loved it. Every week I was basically putting this on. This is Pampeluna Purple right here. Like you guys can see, it's definitely a purple polish. It's one of the brightest that I have for the fall, and I absolutely love it. This one is from OPI and it's Linkin Park At Midnight. I was not a cream polish wearer when Linkin Park After Dark was around and it was so popular, but when I saw that they had a shimmery version of Linkin Park, I definitely had to get my hands on it. And I do have a backup because I know that they discontinued it, and I know that this is dupable and there are other colors like it, but I needed to have the original. The favorite of mine is Catherine the Grape from OPI. I actually wore this as a manicure at a salon and I loved it so much that I went back to the salon to find the name of it just so that I can purchase this polish. And I believe I bought it off of Amazon. I love this so very much. The bottle obviously suffers from ugly bottle syndrome, but it does nothing to negate the beautiful color that this is. It's like a purpley raisin, I feel like pruney kind of color, but I love it. It has like an almost inner glow, guys. Like, it's not a shimmery polish in the sense that it doesn't have like a contrasting shimmer, but there is something about this color that just like pops off the nails. All right, another one from the James Bond collection, and this one is Casino Royale. I love this polish so much. There are dupes, there have been many, many dupes. There are so many colors that look like this, but this is the one that I really, really love to wear. So this color right here, oh my gosh, look at that. Isn't that pretty? It's definitely darker than Pampeluna. Like I said, Pampeluna is like a true purple, and then like this one right here is just like a little bit darker, a little bit more oomph to the sex appeal, in my opinion, is one that's more like a blurple. This is OPI's Do You Have This Color in Stockholm. I absolutely love this color. This was one of my favorite from the year that it came out. It definitely is one of those polishes that you can argue it's purple, it's blue, but I've firmly believe it's in the blue, it's in the purple family color, because when I put it with my blues, it just stands out. Like, it stands out like a sore thumb. And even right now on the viewfinder, I'm looking at it and right here, this nail wheel looks blue, but in person I'm looking at it and it's purple. It's so crazy. I've been talking about this one a lot, and this is Alcatraz Rocks from OPI. It's one of their liquid sands, so it's a textured polish. I have been on the hunt for colors for nail polishes that look just like this, but in a shimmery format, in a glittery format, instead of a liquid sand. I thought that Zoya Sansa was very similar, and there's a Julie G that I purchased that is very similar, but I don't believe I've actually worn the Julie G. This is what Alcatraz Rocks looks like on the nail. This is two coats, completely dry texture. I have not put any top coat on it. I wanted you guys to see how beautiful this polish is. Oh my gosh, I absolutely love it so much. And if it wasn't a liquid sand, I'd love it even more, just because I have a tendency to like regular polishes more than texture polishes, but this one is definitely one of an all-time favorite. Absolutely stunning. And this last one of the classic, this is the classic purples that I was talking about. This one is Every Month is Oktoberfest. Yes, it looks like a red or a berry, but it really isn't, guys. This, you can't tell me that this is not a purple. I just won't believe you, because it's coming off as a purple to me. I absolutely love the way that this looks. This was before Unicorn Pea was discovered by yours truly. Like, I never knew about Unicorn Pea. I didn't know about any of those kind of polishes. I just knew that this polish looks like it glowed off the nails. So that's it, guys. Thank you so much for putting up with this long, drawn out video. I am seriously hoping that I can get all of this formatted in one video instead of two, but if I do get it in two, I'll let you guys know. I will, of course, put everybody's information down below. Please head to their channels, check them out. The ladies who have been involved in this collaboration before and new, or the people that are coming in new to the collaboration, they pick some of the best colors. Like, I seriously, you guys, this summer I spent so much money buying polishes based on recommendations from the Favorites of Summer collection. Like, yeah. I also love the fact that sometimes people mention polishes that I have, and I'm like, oh my gosh, I didn't even think about that polish. Wow, that's like something I would have thought about wearing for fall. Or, you know, it just gives me ideas to branch out of my comfort zone. So thank you guys again so much for watching. If you like what you see, please leave a like, click on the like button down below, and subscribe if you want to see some more. Hope you guys have a great autumn. Bye.